Hello from Gdansk again. This episode is dedicated to all vacuum bagging enthusiasts and those who think about vacuum bagging. I'm not going to teach you how to do vacuum bagging because this topic is covered very well on YouTube. You can Google by your own and learn from number of movies about vacuum bagging. What I will offer today is a few tips and experiences that I made over a period of last decade when dealing with vacuum bagging and an infusion. First of all, I do vacuum bagging only when I want to reinforce the plank or do some fix here and there. But when I make plank from scratch, I do it in infusion. Today, I have one plank being reinforced. We will just, in a minute, go to a second room to demonstrate some of the tips on life piece under vacuum bag. But here I wanted to mention just a couple of things. To begin with, let's talk about vacuum bag. I use this 16 inch wide sleeve. And I highly recommend to take sleeves instead of improvising a sleeve made out of a big sheet of foil, because eventually it may work, but in most cases you will fail with air leaks here and there. Second important consumable is a tacky tape. And this is what seals your vacuum bag. And I used to work with yellow color that was representing high temperature tacky tape dedicated to autoclave process, but it turned to be useless in room temperature processes. So go for black one, because black tacky tape usually is designed for room temperature application, and go for as thick and wide as possible, because the more butyl you have available for sealing, the better sealing results. One of the biggest challenges with vacuum bagging or any vacuum processes is airtightness and having no leaks. And of course, this is a dream situation to have no leak and run the process nice and smooth. However, leak is part of the game, and the important part is to be able to allocate where the leak comes from. And sometimes the leak is big enough that you can hear it with your ear without any instruments, but very often the vacuum bag starts leaking in a completely unexpected place where your ear is not enough to locate the spot. And therefore I decided a few years ago to buy a very precise instrument. It's called ultrasonic leak detector, by the way, made in the USA from AccuTrack, and it has a very handy gooseneck that I can bend to any desired angle and shape, and that allows me to follow along the project and find the leak. It has a indicator showing in a graphic way. It's showing the level of noise, because it detects turbulences, and I need to press the button and the sensor is on, and even slight wind turbulence is enough for indicator to be activated. It's like, you see. I will demonstrate this instrument in action when we move over to a vacuum backed plank. And as long as the resin is not mixed with hardener, you have all the time you need to prepare for your operation. When both components are mixed, then the clock starts clicking twice as fast as normal. And now let's move to the plank for more tips. Another tip is for those who don't want to or cannot heat up the room. I use halogen lamps in this example, 3 halogen lamps. If you set the proper height and span between lamps, you can get a very consistent temperature on the surface of your project. In my case, if I measure the temperature through the whole length, it varies between 38 and 42 degrees, so very consistent. The next step is, how do I secure the end of the plank? In this case, you see the plank has chocks installed, and chocks have a lot of sharp corners that eventually will break your vacuum bag. And many years ago, I came up with the idea of felt shoe. Felt is very thick, and I stitched this felt together, and when I put the felt around the chalk, it also covers the tank from the bottom, because the tank is eventually also a sharp object that can break the bag. So when I put the shoe around the chalk, it goes on the other side and also protects the bag against contact with the tank, and that gives me super protection. Next thing is that when you cut your sleeve, when you cut your vacuum bag, then always extend by at least 30 centimeters or even half a meter, 1 or 2 feet. Extend it beyond your piece, because that will also give you an extra safety when it comes to complicated geometry, like in case of chalk. Having 20 centimeters more than you need is much better than being 1 centimeter too short, and that can cause you a lot of trouble if you cut to length and don't leave extra space, extra length of the vacuum bag. And for the purpose of demonstration, how small leakage, undetectable to the eye, can be dangerous to your part and to your project, I will punch a hole with a needle, punch super tiny hole. I have a second camera watching the pressure gauge and pressure increase under the vacuum bag. I will punch a hole and this. Okay, so the hole is in and the pressure should start increasing now, and there is no chance I can locate the hole, the leak, with my ear, because to the ear it's undetectable. And this is where AccuTrack comes into a play, and it's enough to come close with the gooseneck to the area of the punched hole, and you will immediately see what the indicator is, the bar is showing the leakage. I don't even have to come close. So I can't hear it with my ear, but being in a distance of, like, as you, I don't know if you can see it, but being in a distance of 20 centimeters, it already goes crazy. So I might even make a little too big punch. However, the gauge is slowly moving up, and for me, normally, there is no chance to detect the leak point with the AccuTrack. It's super easy. I mean, now the hole that I punched is so big that I have to decrease sensitivity when the leak is so big. It makes sense to decrease sensitivity of the device. So I press it, and as I come close to the leak point, it eventually starts to display something. So yeah, right. And I know this is exactly the place. And for a situation like this, it's always worth to have tacky tape patches. And I will apply the patch on my hole, and the leak problem is gone. And this is why if you are making more than single piece, it's worth to have such an instrument. And the next tip, always keep sharp objects away of your vacuum bag, because before you even realize, you will punch a hole one or the other way without realizing this, and that may ruin your work. I hope those tricks will help you to run even better vacuum bagging process. And if you are not vacuum bagging by now, maybe the whole episode will encourage you to start and make your first experiments. Think ice.